jam jar shampoos and perfumes, food and things that you'd consume, acids, bases, bottled water when what it's called really matters, shoes and clothes hung on a rack, jewelry or a brand new bag, things you'd buy from shops and stuff when kitne ka matters so much, when unsuitable for heart patients or infants, when it could cause an allergic reaction, when calorie content must be shared or expiry date must be declared, when people want to stake a claim on things or when they want to give their name to things, when Chanel must stand out from raste ka maal, that's when you do label ka istamal. And you, do you think that you're finile? Or if left out, you'd spoil in a while? Are you easily confused with household poisons? Or dangerous if consumed without prescription? Probably not a likely scene, not one that's been or ever would be. So someone, please explain to me why social labels are applied so liberally. That chick in the bar who you see with a smoke? She's trouble, she's beyond hope. Unless girls like that are your type, then go for it, she'll reply with a smile. And that guy over there with his hair in his eyes, if he's caught for possession, I would not be surprised, because people like that are usually high and burdens on the rest of us, am I right? But that guy there, with his shirt tucked in well, he's a stand-up citizen. Can't you just tell that he's a hard worker and has all the right values? If you're getting married, that's the guy you should choose. Are you kidding me? Is this how society works? Is that all that we are? Just habits and words? Why would you judge someone by how they appear without knowing the truth under the visible layers? Why do you care what language I speak or what I do, what I wear or what I eat? What is this insane need to slot everyone into some box nice and neat? And the worst thing about this is that there's no fact on the basis of which these boxes are packed. There's no personality test that defines membership into these boxes to which we are relegated. People are made of different genes, even identical twins are different human beings. There's no category into which we conveniently fall, no formula which helps you sort us all. Labels are for boxes and bottles and things. Labels are not for human beings. We're not notebooks with covers and different names. We're all people. We're different, although we may look the same.